Hi there, it's Jenny Kirk here on another video, and we're going to have a quick look at how to dry brush on models when you're painting models. And this is really a process to highlight detail and make things look a little bit more three-dimensional, a little bit more weathered and worldly worn. And really all it amounts to is it's not strictly speaking dry brushing. Your paint's still wet, but what you're doing is you're dipping your paintbrush into the pot of paint, but then wiping pretty much all of the paint off it. It's almost like cleaning the brush, but there'll still be a very small amount of pigment left on the bristles. And what we're going to be doing with this is actually just sort of scrubbing it over the model that's already been painted. And this leaves a kind of highlight of the paint, but predominantly on the raised detail. So you see all of these rivets and the edges all come to life almost. We're using a colour here. It's Humbrol number 62. And it's the colour that I use to represent rust on so many things, including painting just the sides of the rails. But this particular model we've got here is actually a Pico O gauge buffer stop. This isn't for any of my models, but I've built this for my father, who is getting quite interested in O gauge. But it provides a lovely little simple model to show off this technique. Now, the model itself has been assembled and the base colours painted on it, but we're just going to go over it with this dry brush and get all of the detail. And you can see how it goes from looking like a, well, really like a plastic kit, to looking like it's made out of more real materials and has a much better surface texture and detail level to it. And we can do this with more than one colour. So this is the rust colour, but we could go over with, say, a sooty black colour, and we could give a suggestion of a much dirtier covering on the structure of this particular buffer stop. But also you could go over with a sort of like an olive green colour, give a suggestion of verdigris or algae on it. And you know, you can use many other colours to simulate many other things. And if you use more than one of them, you can build up quite a nice subtle array of colours. Anyway, don't forget to like this video and share it too. And look back through our video history and you'll see all those other lovely videos that we've been doing. There's something there for everybody. Anyway, this is me, Jenny Kirk, saying you take very good care of yourself, and bye for now.